Viewers, welcome back to Father General's YouTube channel. I hope you enjoyed last week's episode on socialization. This week, we'll be looking at participation in social life. And it's from Article 2, Numbers 1897 to 1924.
What does the term authority mean, Father General?
Yeah. Authority. The word authority is a very important word, even in Christianity. Not only for society or not only for the world out there, but even in the church, authority is very, very important. Now, we all know that no society, no group of people can be well ordered nor prosperous without a person being vested with some kind of power or authority to put things into order, even to make laws.
Okay.
It needs some people to be vested with some kind of power. You know, and so that power given to some people, the quality by virtue by which institutions make laws and give orders to men and expect obedience from them is what we call authority.
Okay.
And so that virtue by which some people are given the power to make rule, and when they make the rule, they expect others to obey the rule is what we call authority.
Okay. So why is authority important in the Catholic community?
Authority is very, 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 very important. In fact, from the papacy to the least in
church, authority is very, very important, because once power is invested, once that right is invested into some people and the laws are made, everyone is supposed to follow the law for the purpose of peace and unity in the community, and most importantly for the common good. Yes, most importantly for the common good. So when you read Romans chapter 13 verse 1, Romans 13 verse 1 says, let every person be subject to the governing authorities, for there is no authority except from God, and those that exist have been instituted by God. Therefore, he who resists the authorities resists what God has appointed, and those who resist will incur judgment.
Okay. Romans chapter 13 verse 1. Now what it means is that people do not choose themselves to become leaders in the church. People do not choose themselves to lead the church, to be leaders in the church. It is God who chooses them. And so when leaders are chosen in the church, we who are to be obedient must be obedient or submit ourselves to the leaders and obey whatever rule have been put down. Now by doing so, then we are obeying God who has put those leaders there, even in our state, in our country.
Okay.
So by disobeying the leaders, the authorities of the leaders, we disobey God who gave them that that authority, and then God who chose them to be.
Okay. I think that's
so I hope, yes, that's what it should be.
So Father, how is authority exercised?
Authority is exercised when legitimately one is vested, one is given that right. Okay, so as he's given that right, he expects that people will obey. I mean, will give that corresponding, if you like, collaboration or coexistence. I mean, they should be able to work in
together.
Peace. So, whilst one person leads, must do that, the one who is given authority must do that for the common good, for the good of everyone in the community.
Okay.
It must not be done selfishly. It must be done for the common good.
Okay.
For the common good. It needs humility. It needs God's direction to be done. So it must be done in humility and in wisdom.
Okay. So, yeah. Father, you made mention of the common good.
Yes.
Can you please explain to us what the common
good is? Well, the term common good is very important to us as Christians, that we live in a society, we live in a community, and the good of everyone is what we must desire for.
Okay.
To live in that proportion, in that balance, so that everyone in the community is happy. Let me read what it has there. It said, the common good presupposes respect for the person as such. In the name of the common good, public authorities are bound to respect the fundamental and inalienable rights of the human person. Society should permit each of its members to fulfill his vocation. So in the common good, authorities, those with authorities must respect their subject, and those who are the subject must also respect authority. In there, everybody must fulfill his vocation. You have a vocation, I have a vocation, yes. Someone has a vocation. But in the community, everybody must be happy and fulfill his vocation in the common good.
Yeah.
And that condition must be there for everyone to achieve the common good. Now, the number two says, the common good requires the social well-being and development of the group itself.
Mm-hmm.
The group itself must the well-being of the group must be sought. So development is the epitome of social duties. Certainly, it is the proper function of authority to arbitrate in the name of the common good between various particular interests, but it should make accessible to each what is needed to lead a truly human life. There should be food, there should be clothing, there should be health, there should be work, there should be education and culture, sustainable information, the right to establish a family, and so on. Okay, it says, finally, the common good requires peace. Peace is the stability and security of a just order. It presupposes that authority should ensure by morally acceptable means the security of each and its members. It is the basis of the right to legitimate personal and collective defense. Now, I'm sure that some are surprised whether they're talking about politics or they're talking about the social life.
Yeah.
Social life. Every Christian belongs to the society, and it's our duty to know what society must be like. The common good must be the interest of everybody,
yeah.
Whether you are a Christian or you are not a Christian, but we all live together in the community. And so those with authority must do this so that there's peace, there's understanding, and all that. The common good has more. It says, each human community possesses a common good, which permits it to be recognized in as such. It is in the political community that its most complete realization is found. It is the role of the state to defend and promote the common good of civil society, its citizens, and intermediate bodies. Some people will also ask in another sense, is it good for a Christian to engage in politics?
Yeah.
Yes. Yes, because polis, the word polis, the Greek word polis, means the affairs of the city.
Okay.
So politikos, it means that we are talking about the city. And who are those who make up the city? We make up the city.
Yeah.
So if you decide not to join in to contribute your quota as it was done in the Greek world, some people will decide for you. And once the decision is made, it affects you.
Yeah.
It affects you. So we need to understand that it is about the polis. It is about the polis, about the city. And you are part of the city, and I am part of the city. And this for us, the common good. The last one says, the common good is always oriented towards the progress of persons. The common good always seeks the good of the persons. So authority must make sure that everyone in the community is catered for.
Okay.
Everyone is catered for.
That's wonderful.
Sure.
For the January. So can you give us a summary of this wonderful topic?
Thank you. When we look at also at the community, if you look at the catechism, it also talks about right and participation, or responsibility and participation.
Yeah.
Yes. So people will want to claim this right. They call it right. So yes, I have the right to live. I have the right to enjoy peace. I have the right to grow. I have the right to sustainability. I have the right to this. But to this right are duties and responsibilities. Mm-hmm. So when we are claiming right, yes, I have the right. I have the right to join this church. I have the right to be part of this. I have the right to do this. You must know that you also have a responsibility.
Yeah.
The responsibility is your duty to the community.
Yeah.
So that it is not only about your good, but it's about the good of everybody. So sometimes they say that where your right ends, you know, where your freedom ends, somebody's own also starts from there. So you have the right to enjoy, you have the right to whatever. And if you are playing music in your room, know that there's somebody also in that room sleeping.
Yeah.
And so you must be aware of that person. And for us Christians, we call that charity. Is being charitable to that person. So we have right to enjoy in the community, but for the good of everyone in the community, we also have a responsibility. We must play our responsibility. So in summary, authority is from God, and God gives authority. And according to Romans chapter 13 verse 1, we need to submit to authority, whether political authority, religious authority, social authority, or wherever you find authority. Once it is an authority, it is God that establishes authority. And authority has duties to perform. Authorities have work to do. So, beloved, if you are an authority, know that you have work to bring peace. Know that you have work to bring peace. to bring unity, to bring development, to bring sustainability, to bring everybody to fulfill his vocation. And that is the work you have as a leader. That's the work I have as one having authority. Let us all play our part well and know that in the common good, the good of everyone should be our interest. Everyone must try to seek the good of everyone. It's not easy, but it is possible.
There you have it. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe to Father General's YouTube channel. Do join us next week for another exciting episode. Father, give us the benediction.
Thank you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may the blessings of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you now and forever. Amen.
Amen.